The following banding techniques are used for our tidal marsh sparrow project and can be used with other songbird species. We use 12-meter long nets called mist nets to capture these sparrows. The mist nets are 2.5 meters tall and are suspended between two poles. Since we are in a salt marsh with low vegetation and no trees, we can prop up poles in the soft ground with the appropriate support and tension without using ropes, stakes, or trees to anchor the poles. A very important step in setting up mist nets is making sure the area is clear of any vegetation which can injure birds caught in the net. Since we are in a salt marsh, this is often not an issue. Once the nets are properly set up, we return to our banding station and wait for the birds to fly into the nets. Since the nets are thin and thread-like, it looks invisible, and therefore birds will passively fly into the nets because they cannot see them. Since the nets are often in direct sunlight, we check them at least every 15 minutes. We check every net and make sure that all birds are extracted and that vegetation or insects are cleared out of the nets before returning back to the banding station for the next round of net checks. Our banding station has all the tools needed to process a bird. These tools include calipers, bands, banding pliers, wing cord ruler, and various buffers for our fecal and blood samples. We will also actively drive birds into the nets by running and clapping. We aren't always successful in getting a bird into the net. We corralled this bird into the net. Even when we don't get a bird, we always have to check the nets. Here we successfully caught our female. Unfortunately, playback, which is the use of recorded songs and calls, is ineffective for most of the sparrows in the salt marsh since they are not territorial. For territorial species like song sparrows, playback can be used to lure the males into the nets. The song of another individual of the same species causes male birds to fly around searching for the source of the sound and defend its territory. By placing a Bluetooth speaker near a mist net, we can readily attract males into the net. Females are sometimes captured by playback, though not as frequently as the males. It is important we don't use playback too often in the same area, as males will spend all their time investigating and won't forage. By setting up an array of nets and waiting for birds to passively fly in, we can estimate survival rates, how many young are produced each year, and how many young survive to the breeding age. In our project, however, we estimate these measures by monitoring the success of the nests. Therefore, we can use playback and drive birds into the nets by clapping, which would otherwise bias the estimates compared to passive netting. Since the salt marsh is incredibly flat and exposed, driving the birds is very effective. It is important that both people and birds are safe during this process. We take caution not to stress birds out by chasing too much, which can disturb nesting females, and we keep track of how long we are netting in the area. We also pay attention to the female's behavior. If the weather is too foggy or too hot, we will not net that day. As soon as we see a bird in the net, we run over and extract the bird. Birds caught in the net stay still because the mist nets have pockets that wrap the bird's wings like a blanket. Here, the bird is only caught by its leg. To extract the bird, we grab the bird's body and begin working the bird out of the net the way it came in. Starting by removing the net from the wing, then the head, then the other wing, we can quickly and efficiently extract the bird from the net. We aim to extract the bird in under 5 minutes, but often extractions can be done in a matter of seconds. If a bird is extremely tangled or is starting to stress out, we will cut the net with scissors that we carry to help speed the extraction. We also check to see if the bird has bands already and to check for any existing injuries. By using mist nets with the mesh size appropriate for the species we are working with, we can minimize the likelihood of injury resulting from the net. The likelihood of an injury is low, but we will prioritize and help birds that are prone to stress. We transport captured birds in our passive fecal sampler, which is a brown paper lunch bag with a grate above a weighboat. This allows us to collect a fecal sample from the bird in a minimally invasive way. We make sure that we are always checking every net on time, in this case every 15 minutes, to minimize stress on the birds. We have a protocol that we follow to help minimize stress and mistakes, and we constantly reevaluate our process.